A lifeline's been offered to Auckland's beleaguered St James Theatre that stood vacant for 16 years. Today the Arts Minister's pledged $15 million towards restoring the historic building that's in total disrepair. It's hoped work can get underway next year so that by its centenary in 2028 it can finally reopen to the public. But the government money comes on the condition that Auckland Council matches its investment. Business correspondent Corazon Miller explains.
These cold and rotting ruins are all that's left of this theatre's former glory.
It's come to the end of its operational life.
For years it sat vacant as the arts community fought to find a way to make it fit for royalty once again.
We did it! Yeah. So thank you.
Today the government giving greater certainty that this won't be the end of St James.
We'll be investing $15 million to support the restoration.
A project that until now hasn't been a priority.
Why can you justify spending this amount of money now?
We shouldn't forget the value that arts, culture and heritage brings. It is about sustainable careers in the arts sector as well. We all get to enjoy that. So even when we are experiencing some challenging times, it's important that we continue to invest in and focus on the arts.
There are caveats to that investment. Council must abide by its own $15 million pledge, a promise first made under Mayor Len Brown, one that survived the latest budget cuts.
All credit to the Mayor and the Council for maintaining that commitment, because the Mayor and the Council can see that St James and Queen Street is absolutely critical for the success of Queen Street.
There's a catch here too though. Renovations must begin by the end of June 2024. The theatre's owner confident he'll make it, and confident the funding's enough for him to complete the building restoration.
I'm pretty confident that this will complete the structural upgrade and protect the building for the next 100 years.
The theatre's centenary is in 2028.
It's an occasion which brings to Auckland a touch of London's enchantment.
In its prime, it hosted Queen Elizabeth II. And there have been many international and local acts to grace the stage. A fire closed its doors in 2007. Its owner hopeful they'll reopen within 5 years. And to the tune of one of our own.
I'd love to see an iconic New Zealand musician. I'd love to see Neil Finn do his iconic Seven Worlds Collide.
A dream that's now one step closer to reality. Corazon Miller, One News.